Middle of my sentence.
No, you said are we good? And I said, you said yeah.
And then I said, yeah, I'm trying to. And then you were like, yeah.
I don't care about. And you're all alone. You should just tune in to the Blaster.
Blaster on at 8 o'clock every other Monday or time that we're at home. What's up, guys?
How's it going? Literally don't give a shit about your emotes. You just take that shit home. I don't care. What I do give a shit about is Blast Zone. What's good? Ow. Fuck. I hit my knuckle. How's it going, guys? Welcome to Blast Zone. We're back. It's been a while. I think we're live. We're live, right?
Yo, quick question. Do you think I should use the... So you know like that emote where the DX... So should that be like TK a sellout or just TK a sell?
Sell.
Alright, yeah. Sellout's too long.
Yeah.
Alright.
Anyway, how's it going, guys? Let me tweet this out. Let me get filter everybody getting in here. All the little ducklings flying in.
Did you guys watch the shit from the White House?
No. How'd that go?
That was pretty interesting. Like, me and Fats and Moose and Tiffany all went out to go hang out with, like, Elspeth and Bijou and some of the streamers that, like, and OKJan. Some of the streamers that were cool with. And it was dope. And then, like, we watched it today. And, like, honestly, they were really just talking about healthcare. And, like, well... I'm not gonna lie, the shit was bad informative, made me want to sign up for healthcare right now, so.
Yeah.
But Neorec actually came over yesterday and helped me sign up there.
Oh, I thought you were saying Neorec actually went. I was like, no, he didn't.
Could you imagine? Neorec gets to the White House, I'm like, alright, this man is finessing too hard right now.
That's awesome.
That would be, I'd be impressed, I couldn't even be mad.
Shit. I couldn't even be mad, I'm like, you know what, you got it, man.
Finds his way into that shit. That's wild. Alright, let me know if we're live, guys. I think we're live.
Yeah, we're live.
We're live? Okay, cool. Yeah, my thing isn't updating. Are you guys seeing this new dashboard? Twitch Live dashboard?
It's very confusing.
Yeah.
The what?
Twitch has a new dashboard. When you start streaming, you'll see it for the first time. This is weird.
What are you trying to say? I don't stream?
I mean... I try to say I don't stream. What kind of Blast Zone? This is like the first Blast Zone of the month, man. Like, this is crazy.
Yeah, I mean, look. All right. You know what's funny? This is actually starting to upset me. Very much, but...
Very much?
I keep seeing these people bring up the idea of doing a podcast for Smash, and I'd be like...
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, so, you know, Blast Zone's easily the most popular podcast for Smash right now. Like, without me even having to look up facts or anything, I don't know any other podcasts that are going right now.
Yeah.
The last few podcasts I've seen, I've only seen his ideas, and I didn't see them take off.
Yeah.
Blast Zone... has been tipping, has hit 1,000 views before, has been tipping about 500 every time, and somehow no one remembers us. I'm like, okay.
Well, you want to know what it is because we don't expand out to the other places. So, like, I had it on iTunes for a while, but updating on iTunes is a fucking chore, and you have to pay money every single month for that. Then there are some other ones, like, I tried YouTube for a while, but that's super cumbersome. Like, we need to get somebody to just do it. We need, like, somebody to hire that.
We need to hire someone to take the VOD and put it on YouTube?
Yes. We need to do that. Like,
I'm actually in the process of trying to get my mods to do more like that anyway, so, I'll put it out there. 2017.
I'm saying, because, like, I feel like it could work, but nobody knows about it. Like, we get you know, pretty good viewers, but nobody ever knows about it. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. This is Blast Zone. I'm Coney. This is Black Plague, TK Breezy, EE. We're talking Super Smash Brothers. Last show we did was, like, 2 weeks ago? I think we're mostly 3 weeks?
Like 3 weeks, homie.
Was it? All right, we're stretching out. It's supposed to be, the show supposed to be every other week. Started as every week, then that didn't work out because of the travel schedule, then it was every other week, but then, you know, Smash is blowing up. These guys are getting, you know, more and more gigs. More and more stuff is happening, man. Smash is in a good place right now, so TKSL. And thank you, Pwned Noob, with the most generic name I've ever seen. How did you get that name? Good lord.
That's my nigga.
that blew my mind. Dude's name is just Pwned Noob. As you can see, I've got the VG, the jersey washed for Zero Saga, which I will be hoping to attend. You guys are attending it, obviously.
Yeah, I think actually we're going to go back to the... So, I put myself on blast right here. For the last few weeks, I've been pretty lazy. Or not a few weeks, but the last few...
Oh, did I miss a Constable Lemon? Thank you for the 12 months. I'm sorry.
Months.
There's a year.
I say the last few months. I've been pretty lazy on dressing up. One, because I really haven't bought any new shirts. And two, didn't really feel like the need to, especially some of these tournaments that didn't deserve. Like, I mean, Canada Cup, there's no way I was dressing up a Canada Cup. But so watching some commentators like the other day, and I realized, you know, even if the tournament's small, these guys still got ties on and stuff, and it just looks professional. So I think 2017 starts probably gonna get back into dressing up. At least shirt and tie. I don't know about the blazer. I'm not really feeling the blazer too much. But the shirt and tie will be coming back out for the beginnings of 2017. So my bad, Phil.
It's all good, man. You know what? I appreciate that.
The direct apology?
I appreciate that, and that's only going to elevate us even further, man. Because when the fire is spitting and it's matching too, ain't no stopping us, nigga. There you go.
It's beautiful. You guys are going to be all over the map in 2017.
Yeah, whatever, man. You never stop dressing up, Saint Cody. We sit out here fucking hoodies and thugging out on.
Yeah, nigga, I see you on the low with your
fucking I don't go to a lot of shit, so I got to make a good impression, because otherwise I'm not going to get fucking hired anywhere. Some asshole going to 3 events a year. Like, no. I come in, I razzle dazzle, and then I
my
come
nigga,
back
Sky, next. Sky did it on one event. Like, you could do it on 3.
That's true. Yeah.
I believe in you.
Guy never dressed up at that. That's the funniest thing. He came in. I remember him coming into Paragon LA on the very last day, just for top 8. Came in, fucking hoodie, some lewd anime shirt, and I was like, I was like kind of dressed up, and I just went back to my room and put on a t-shirt.
Doesn't that suck though? Like when you sit down with the person you're commentating, and they're like, you know. I got a button up, a tie, a blazer, a scarf. Have you guys seen that picture of what's that tournament Pierce did, where he looked like a fucking jet set radio character? You guys
with that fucking scarf
with
on?
The scarf and the glasses.
Yeah.
And
I remember that stupid shit.
He looked like an NPC you visit to get level up. Like, I don't know what that was.
he looked like an extra in a Bleach anime, man.
He looked like a No More Heroes assassin. Like, he's one of the bosses. Like,
welcome to the Rose Zone. Where?
That's my nigga.
You have a nice outfit. You about to get roasted. Yeah. Also, make sure you guys retweet Tony's tweet so we can get these views.
Yeah, please. Let's get people in here. Let's let everybody know. Because apparently nobody knows when they talk about Smash Podcast. They're like, oh yeah, why isn't there one? Why doesn't everybody talk about it? That's our fault. Well, really, it's my fault. But
hey,
really, everybody should be in here.
When you guys wanted a Smash Podcast?
Literally right here.
Well, there is one. Come through.
What a surprise. The only problem with this new dashboard is that it doesn't seem to work. It doesn't make sense. So anyway, alright, let's talk about Smash.
We've been wasting
time too much.
Like, Warchamp did some cool thing where he made like a little mini dashboard for you, so I'm gonna look into. Did you just make tea?
Yeah.
Why don't you use the kettle? All right, you got it. Don't. Anyway.
I'm going to use the Warchamp one after this stream, because like, I don't want to fuck with it while, you know. Like, I'll do it for the next one. But,
yeah, I'm going to mess around with it. But yeah, Warchamp, I see you out here, bro.
Yeah, thank you, my friend. Just like I'm trying to mess with Capagen. Capagen would be great for Blast Zone.
So why don't you have it up right now?
I got to figure that out. Yeah, yeah, okay. I'm going to look at that. All right, anyway, thank you guys for tuning in. So let's talk Smash Brothers. So first off, events that we missed. So all three of us were at UGC Open Smash. Tiny event, tons of competition, though. I think, like, so many of the top 50 PGR were there trying to stake their claim on the $40,000 pop bonus that was set. Of course, Armada and Zero both winning, walking away with, I think, $15,000 in their pocket, plus whatever was the amount of the pot. So that's just an absolutely staggering amount. So from an event perspective, I mean, because this isn't the first Smash event they've ever done. They've done one like a long, long time ago, but I feel like it was a huge success. What do you guys think?
UGC?
Yeah.
Yeah, UGC was amazing. That's UGC, awesome. In my opinion, was the best tournament I've been to this year. Like, it's up there with Shine and Big House as far as production and weight. Like, yeah, no, I mean, like, that's how good it was to me. Like, but then again, at the same time, the same team that was working on Big House was working on UGC. The only problem with UGC that I found was they need to include crowd mics. Whenever crowd mics aren't there, like, as a spectator, because I've done this, like, I've been on stage, I've been in commentary, like, when I know what happens when a crowd mic's not there. Like, I know that, like someone's speaking and it's coming directly to the crowd, and then you're like, everybody get hype, and then you could barely hear the crowd because they're like a good 30, 40 feet away. So it's like, oh, okay, wow, it's cringe. And it's like not really cringe if you're there, but like if you're a spectator who doesn't know that Kyle Wright might exist.
Yeah.
You know, you just you don't really think about that. So they definitely need crowd mics, and hopefully next time they have crowd mics.
Can I make another point? While we're doing the top eight introductions and the emceeing shit, can you guys let somebody fucking know if Trophy Room is the song playing? Like, I just found that out. I listened back to the top eight. I watched it with you guys. And during all the, like, quiet moments in between, it was fucking Trophy Room. That's not hype music. The chat's gonna fall asleep. Who decided that?
Trophy Room is... You talking about the Melee Trophy Room?
It was the...
Oh, wait. Wait, no. I'm thinking
It was a Trophy Room. It was the rest area. The do.
Yeah.
Do. No, what the fuck? Can we get?
Oh yeah.
I'm trying to MC. I'm trying to like get people interested in the next match. And no, I just had that fucking ambient. No,
that's a terrible
song.
Idea. That's terrible. Yeah, Bear. Like he's trying to. I don't understand Bear because he's like he does not like Swan Lesson, which I, you know, whatever, I get that. But like you can't not like Swan Lesson and then put that on the menu. Like yeah. You know what I mean? Like that's just not how it works. Like the only song I feel like that's definitely should be on the menu all the time is the one that we always used. That joint goes. That joint goes. But the other Trophy Room is, I mean, all the Brawl songs pretty much go. And I'm actually like okay with the Smash 4 theme as long as it's not on any stages.
Yeah.
So
I agree. So that's my major lesson learned. Also, I tweeted about this, but I didn't know this. I learned after dinner, and you guys helped me with this, I learned after dinner at UGC that black people have a totally different version of the Happy Birthday song.
We jammed that song.
Yeah.
Y'all just blew my mind with that shit.
You didn't. I'm surprised you've never heard that before.
Like,
I swear to God, I've never heard that. So it was EE's birthday, and they came out with a piece of cake. And, of course, everybody's like, happy birthday to you. And then D1, who's sitting to my right, is like, all right, hit the black version. Happy birthday! And everybody in the table, everybody at the fucking table pops off. And I'm...
Happy birthday to you.
And me and Austin are like, did you know about this? I didn't know about this. Did you? Like, we had no idea. That blew my mind. So if anybody, and you can see all the black people in the chat, like, they know. It's a secret. It's their shit. So your secret's out. Anyway, that was my biggest reveal from UGC. Awesome event. Awesome staff. Probably one of my favorite events of the year just because of, like I said, it was kind of small and cozy. And I really got to, like, spend time with people who I normally don't get to spend time with at events because we're all so busy. And I got to, like, actually talk with people, like, top players and, like, people that, you know, I haven't really interacted with all that much. So it was awesome for me. I loved it.
Yeah, it was a really good event. Definitely will go back. I hope they have like two UGCs a year. That'd be sick.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it that much. Like the only thing I wasn't a fan of was the area. But when I saw that 24-hour
The area fucking sucked. Like
when I saw that 24-hour Steak and Shake though, man, everything changed.
Yeah.
When I saw that price of Steak and Shake, it's like, I mean,
shit was good as fuck too.
That was the first time we didn't have to. Like,
you love that milkshake. Shut up, Zach.
It's funny because, like, you know, we
all. Are you brand new now?
It was.
Are you brand new now? You like a milkshake now?
It was all right.
We always talk about how we have to like eat, the way we have to eat at tournaments. So it seems like we have to spend so much money, and then so we found a Steak and Shake. We only ate there twice because we still decided to spend a bunch of money eating lavish because Anti existed. God damn it.
Yeah, fuck Anti.
Y'all went to Porter's every night, man.
Yeah, I'm saying that was Anti's fault.
Yeah, really.
I'm trying to keep up for no reason. Like this nigga get all his shit expensed.
Oh, while we're blasting people, did y'all know that EE tried a medium rare steak for the first time this event? He always gets his shit well done with ketchup. Did you know that? I didn't know that.
It was good too. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed the medium cut.
I'm sick.
I mean, I gotta learn, right? I gotta learn.
Took you long enough, man. Like,
I was impressed. I knew it was good when I didn't have to call for ketchup.
He said with ketchup. Like, that's what I'm sick about. Like, man, really asked it. Ketchup.
You got the chat going in on me.
That's what you get. Let this be a learning experience.
Yo, spare me. I'm sorry, guys. I'll never go back, though. I'll never go back.
All right, so UGC, awesome event. Definitely hope they keep pumping these things out, man. I'm hoping that... You know, it was kind of small this year just because they didn't give it much time to, like, grow in terms of building the hype. a lot of people didn't know about it, but I'm hoping that the top players are all talk and, you know, sing its praises, and then we'll see a much bigger turnout for next year. So that happened. Before we get into the Smashbox, which I do want to touch on briefly, if you guys have opinions on that. So this past weekend, what was the event's name? I'm drawing a blank here. Battle on the Strip?
Battle of LA? Battle... You talking about that one?
No, but that was UCLA? Funny.
That was a funny-ass event.
Smash City LA. That's not the one I'm talking about, but that
Oh, you talking about Eden? You talking about Eden?
Is that the one? It was the one that,
The Melee one?
Leo
one. Oh, I know what you're talking about.
Showdown.
Showdown.
Okay, yeah. That's it. Yeah. It was...
Whatever it was, Leo won it again. So, you know, him and Mr. R had to play for the 19th time. Mr. R still can't do it.
Nope.
I don't know.
You ever notice that after Leo beats Mr. R, though, Mr. R always has that positive tweet afterwards, like, well, you know, my bayonet, I really feel like I'm getting a lot closer. Just got to get some combos down and shit. And I'm always just like, this nigga's getting beat so much, he's trying to talk himself into the fact he has a chance.
Leo's brainwashing him.
Just, I love Robin. I love Robin, but I wait for that tweet every time, man.
Just a few more weeks, guys. The Bandana's coming a lot. Like, we love you, Mr. R. We love you, but, like, that...
Love you, bro.
That guy's a demon. Like, Leo is his demon, and I hope he gets through it eventually. So, yeah, that happened. The Smash City LA stream was one of the funniest things I've ever fucking seen. Like, I don't know who was manning that, but that was the funniest shit.
Apparently, it was Machinima.
Dude, that fucking Ness.
the Ness tweet nailed it!
Dude, that guy was like 40!
That dude, and he was hollering, he was going, look, I know, I don't care what he was going to say. That man was definitely trying to get at that fox the whole time, man. He was... So, yeah, man, you want a team sometime? Like,
Be my Lucas? Like, this nigga was creeping.
Yeah. That was wild. And D1, bless his heart, trying to keep it together, just... Staring at the screen,
though. Yo, remember, like, I could just tell that they never cut back to you, or they never say, alright, coming back to you, because D1 would always be like...
Yeah.
exactly. Deadass.
That shit was...
We need cues! If you're watching this,
yeah.
We need cues.
D1 said that they were in a separate room, away from all that stuff, and that they only had a TV that had the gameplay on. So when niggas was playing, they weren't sure who was playing. Like, it was like, D1 said they were panicking because it was Kira Flax versus somebody, and they were like, we don't know his opponent. So they just kept saying, like, the Fox or whatever. If you watch the whole start of it before they tell who it is, they say, oh, good up there by the Fox.
Yeah, no, it was actually terrible. And then I got the end, and, like, at the end, you could see where they're sitting at. That little desk that they had set up made it look, it looked like two... grown-ass man sitting at, like, a fucking, Play-Doh, like, kid's desk or fucking... I was like, what the hell is this? So then D1's like... He's, like, doing his sign-off, and then Troop is cut.
Yeah, just cut him off.
That shit was...
Have you guys ever seen the Eric Andre show? Have you ever watched the Eric Andre show? Do you know what that is?
I know what it is. I don't think I've watched
it. It's basically, this was that in Smash form. Like, it just makes no fucking sense. It just chaos.
Dude, those fucking mics right in their face. The whole time. Those big ass dick mics.
That fucking dick mic, yeah. I was like, yo.
It's literally a dick mic.
I wouldn't have been like as mad if they like would have put the mics like down and they were coming like this, but they were like literally coming.
Yeah, it was assaulting. That was crazy.
Big burly dude just standing over you with his dick out, like
that was a nightmare. Oh, so another thing that I wanted to bring up that I actually wanted to highlight that we kinda just skipped over, that's my fault. So, and I figured that somebody would ask this in a tweet, by the way. Tweet us, hashtag BlastZone. You can talk to us directly. Ask us questions. We will get to all of them, I think. We usually do. ESAM's run at UGC. I know it's really early to talk because, you know, people can have a good bracket. People can get lucky, whatever. You guys think he's back? I know I'm putting you on the spot. I know you're swinging in the wind. You don't know, but what do you think?
I don't like to say people are back after one tournament. Because... You know, once again, Smash 4.
But I'm making you do it, so...
Alright, well, if we're going to say, then no, he's not back, man. It was a good run for him this time.
Damn.
Well, if he does it again, then I'll be like, alright, man, maybe ESAM's back. But I don't want to take this run and be like, you know, become back on the ESAM train, and next thing you know, nigga goes to his next fucking tournament, and he gets 17th, and I'm like, well, okay, well, that train was short, you know, one-car train.
Yeah, I feel you. I feel like this is... it's an interesting spot for East Ham. My take on it is, one, I think it's terrific that he excels at the Bayonetta matchup. Like, the way the meta's going, I think that's going to be very, very pivotal with him. So I think that's great. But I don't know if I want to say he's, like, back. I think this will start, like, a streak of East Ham not bustering, like, oh, losing to a Falcon in pools at Evil. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't think that shit's going to happen anymore. I think he'll be consistently out of pools, a threat in bracket. He'll get his top eights here and there, or, you know, he'll get, you know, nothing less than, you know, 17th or whatever, right? But I don't think we're going to see, like, 33rd, 49th kind of bullshit anymore. I think a wave of consistency is coming back to him. Because he said that, you know, moving back to Florida, he feels like, you know, he's kind of starting to redevelop his style and stuff. So I think we're going to see a much more consistent East Ham. I'll say that.
Okay. I'm only asking you guys because I don't know if you guys saw the GR Trash video. It was very good on the East Ham run. But I hope that people got clips of these, you guys saying that, because if he has another good run, they're going to use that. So there you go.
Thanks, GR Trash.
That. Yeah, that was actually a very good video. I hope that dude makes more. That was awesome. I'm kind of with you guys, but I think that goes without saying. One good event, awesome work. Let's do it again. Is he going to Sarasota?
No,
I think he's going to Parking Grass because I know he saw easy money. So fucking his biggest competition, I think, Parking Grass right now is DK Will. So
yeah,
maybe if all right. So Kakajin could potentially beat him if he fucking went, but he hasn't even like registered. And he lives there, so I just don't even know if he's gonna go in the first place. But yeah. I'm sure there's other reasons why he wanted to go to Park on the Grass, but, I mean, first and foremost, you know it's got to be about that money. Like,
yeah, probably.
Well, from what I understand, it's I quote, I'm not going to support the event of somebody who doesn't support me.
I feel that, too.
Yeah,
I feel that. In regards to Zero's feelings.
Sam definitely do not fuck with each other, but then again, Zero doesn't fuck with a lot of people over whatever reasons, but, you know.
Still? Like, you
I said a lot of people, not me.
No, I'm talking about Esam and him. I didn't know that they were still, like...
Yeah, well, I mean, because Zero was... But, like, the last time I remember them talking, Zero was super butthurt because he was playing against some Bayonetta or something on his stream, and...
Esam was, like, why don't people DI out of this, right?
Yeah, why don't people DI, and he was like, no one cares what your shitty opinions, you try to stay relevant, blah, 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 some other shit, and then he was like, I think he blocked him after that, which is like, oh. That's one way to get, you know, that's one way to get it off your chest.
Yeah. Okay. I didn't know that they were still beefing, but Sam has been... Whoops, I accidentally hit the soundboard button. Ignore that sound. I'm going to skedaddle out of here. So, yeah, I didn't know they were still beefing. Maybe the dude holds a grudge longer than I realized. All right, so all that, don't park on the grass. Don't really want to talk about it because, like you said, in terms of competition, it is in the shadow of the much larger event, perhaps the most stacked tournament in... the history of Smash 4, you guys think? Maybe? Zero
Saga? Nah, Renai's not there.
No, that's true. Yeah.
Nah, yeah, you need more Japanese representation. If you're talking about stacked American tournament, though, I mean, I give you that.
Yeah. But, this tournament is...
Yeah, I mean, so was UGC. That shit was stacked. UGC had, like 70 of the top 50, top 100, like, there. Just, like, out of nowhere. I was like, wait, I didn't know you were coming. Yeah, I'm here, man. What's up?
It was overshadowed by the fact that it didn't have that many entrants, but again, that's because it was announced late, and after all these other big events had been announced, people had already planned and spent money. But like, yeah, that was a very difficult tournament. That's why I was so excited about that top eight. I really had a great time commentating that top eight, because I just thought every one of those matches was sensational. So.
And you know, like that Bowser switch is gonna get like thousands and thousands of views. Like.
Oh, that was crazy. Yeah. he went in.
That's wild. So Zero Saga, for anybody that doesn't know the whole story about this saga thing and why it's so important, so, and I feel like this has been talked about a million times, but just in case you're new, if you're stopping in to the stream for the first time, or if you just saw Super Smash Bros. For Wii U and want to talk, okay. So the reason that the Saga series is important is because for the last year, 2GG, an organization in SoCal, has been flying out top players from different regions all over the U.S., sometimes all over the world. They flew out a Japanese top player. And the idea is that they come to SoCal and they try their hand at, you know, SoCal's local competition. A bunch of people show up and have a great time. It's a big tournament. Thing is, nobody has ever won their own saga. There was KTAR Saga, Pink Fresh Saga, Abadongo Saga. There have been all kinds of saga, Fatality, all that stuff. But nobody's ever won their own. Now, the people have won other ones, but nobody's ever won their own. Now, what 2GG is doing for this upcoming weekend is Zero Saga. Zero is... It was the undisputed best player in the world. I think he's that now again.
Easily,
yeah. I think he's definitely come back to that. And it's very much, like, he's slated to win it all, right? There's no chance he's not going to. But if you look at the people that are coming, it has so many people that have beat him before. Not that I think that's a particularly relevant thing, because, you know, I don't know if they would win another set. But so many people that have beat him before, so many people that have beat him multiple times, like Allied, Larry, people like that. There are an absurd amount of killers there, and Zero's got to basically wade through them all to break the curse and win his own saga. And it's going to be great. It's going to be awesome. And all three of us are going. I believe I'm going, as far as I know. This stuff is always kind of up in the air. So that's happening this weekend. So everybody, you guys are going to want to tune into that. That is on twitch.tv/2ggaming. I can't overstate how crazy this event is going to be. This is going to be wild.
Shit's going to be sick.
Yeah.
I'm glad they decided to go big above and beyond and go see this Vegas venue instead of whatever venue they've been using. Not that the venue's been bad, but
yeah.
At first I was like, when E got his own saga, and they were like, "Oh man!" Like they were like, "Who else do you want to come out in saga?" And they didn't even put me in that poll.
Yeah,
I was like, "All right, like, what are you trying to say, champ?" And then someone's like, so a bunch of people tweeted him like, "Yo, why not? Why is Tiki Breeze not here?" He's like, "Oh, he'll get. You know, we have different plans for him." And I think that was probably the Blast Zone saga.
Yeah,
but
once which E is came still back, upcoming, maybe.
Once EE came back and said, what the venue was like, I was like, all right, man, you good.
For my life, my nigga. Like,
wait, what's up with the venue?
No, the venue.
He had. This is early 2GG.
Yeah, this is early 2GG. So, story time. Before 2GG went to Esports Arena, they might as well have been in a crack house, man. The venue was in this part. I saw signs for Compton. That's how I knew I was in trouble. Secondly, the venue itself didn't have no name on it, right? It didn't have no name on it. The door was just unlocked. So I'm thinking to myself, look, real shit, Champ ain't renting this motherfucker out. He just anticipating nobody's gonna come say nothing.
He just found it. He was like,
just a bunch of niggas mobbed up. Who's gonna say something? Ain't nobody saying nothing, right? But then you know it starts to get a little darker. You know the goons come around. Like, yo, what's going on? Oh, yeah, y'all play Madden up in there? No, nigga, we don't play Madden. It's a Smash Brothers tournament, man. Ouch. Boy, I tell you.
Yo, speaking of, that's actually the funniest question I get. Like, whenever someone's like, so what you doing out here? Yeah. I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm commentating for an esports tournament. Oh, was y'all playing, like, Madden and shit?
It's always Madden, man. Always Madden or 2K.
Yeah, Madden. Oh, y'all play, like, 2K and shit? Nah, then you got
an answer for that?
Nah, we play Super Smash Brothers for the Wii U entertainment system. Like,
I say
oh, there's... yeah, Silent Car Ride.
I don't know about you. I say yes. They're like, you play Madden? I'm like, yeah. Because I'm not trying to admit to them I'm doing Mario versus Pikachu. I'm like, yeah, I'm football. Like,
the Jack in the Box by the old 2G venue had bulletproof glass between me and who I was placing my order with. I was like, it's noon. I'm like, what are you worried about? Like, you don't come around here often, brother.
Hold on, man. You just got a sub. Some meeting coming through the Twitch file.
Oh, who's that? Oh, ooh, wow, you having to come through. And
I got it. I see everything.
Thank you, Submedia. Thank you.
I see everything.
Hottest peach. Thank you very much. Yeah, I haven't been there yet. Well, I guess we'll never go there because they moved to Esports Arena.
Am I often having conversation at airport bars? I've never had a conversation at airport bars. Like, the last time, the first time I went to an airport bar was with Mango because I was at my flight, like, 3 hours early, and then he was at his flight 3 hours early, so me, him, and Blair, and Matt.Zeb went to the... speaking of, I gotta get Matt.Zeb some $1 million. Totally forgot. We went to the bar and just drank a couple beers and just talked. But like, I never like really been just sitting there. And someone was like, "Excuse me, are you TK Breezy?" I did have a lady on the last day of I forgot which tournament this was, but I had a lady take a picture of me with her son because I was in my TK Breezy VG jacket.
Yeah.
And I guess
yeah.
She thought I was on some like major team, so she was like,
"Oh,
and you?" She's like, "So what do you guys do?" And I was like, "Oh yeah, I'm a professional video game commentator." Oh, that's so cool. Can you take a picture of my son? Yeah, yeah man. Like, okay. I did that, and that was dope. I mean, it felt nice to, like, have someone recognize you, even though they didn't know that, like, what I actually did. They, like, still were like, oh, he must be, like, some type of famous. And I was like, oh.
Word. It's a nice feeling, man. That's why I just started embracing the Shofu shit. I'm like, fuck it.
Wow.
You gonna make me feel really special, nigga? I'm gonna take
Shofu now. Like,
I'm gonna take it and a free drink to come with it. I don't give a fuck anymore. So,
I told you about that. I told you I got the story about that dude who saw me at Uniqlo and said, "Yeah, I told you. I think I told you that last
Uniqlo?
Time."
Uniqlo?
Like, oh yeah, you were with Nira, right?
Yeah, I was in Uniqlo and.
Why were you at Uniqlo
Nira? It was Black Friday and. They had an amazing sale on socks. I mean, you see these socks right now, bro. Yeah. Some socks right there.
What are those pants? Hold on. Right, oh, bro. Thank you, Sus Studios. Thank you, Sus Studios.
I'm a true American. Hold up.
Nigga, mango in the shit.
It says New York right here.
Thank you, Sus Studios.
On God, B. On God. I got the hottest pants in the game free. Like,
oh, my God. I've never seen those
pants, bro. So, anyway. So we go there, and dude is like, so I walk in, and me and Nero are like looking at some shit, and he's like, this guy from across is like looking at me, and I was like, all right, this guy probably knows who I am. So, like, about 10 minutes past, he comes over, he's like, excuse me, you Cheeky Breezy? And I was like, yeah. He goes, oh, what's up, man? I didn't know if it was you. Like, I didn't want to be, like, if it wasn't you, it was going to be awkward. I was like, so what I was thinking was, if he walked up to someone else and they said, are you TK, and he said, are you TK Breezy, and it wasn't me. Like, you could just be like, oh, my bad, I thought you were someone I knew. Like, I don't think that's that awkward. Unless it's like, are you TK Breezy? And it's like, actually, EE? And it's like, the fuck? Like, you know what I mean? Like, then I'd be like, what the fuck? But so he was like, yeah, man, really love your commentary, and I love what you did at the summit. And I was like,
ooh.
So I was just, okay. I was like, all right, yeah, no, I mean, thanks. You know, you gotta do what you gotta do. That's, I was like, I paused for
you
a quick second.
You said you gotta do what you gotta do?
Yeah, I was like, sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. He's like, yeah, man, you know, thanks for what you do. I was like, all right, man.
What the fuck does that mean?
You don't even know me?
I'm telling you, man, he got you mixed up from Battle of the Five Gods.
I don't believe so. No one loves what I did in Battle of Five Gods. Come on, man. All people that love what I did at Five Gods are the same people that, like, will watch Melee and Smash 4. If you watch just Smash 4, you didn't watch. And if you watch just Melee, you fucking hate me, so.
Fuck a Melee. They'll never see this. Fucking Melee. Alright, Zero Saga happening. UGC already happened. Battle Royale already happened. So, okay, one more thing before we get into user questions, really quick. Smashbox. There's been a lot of debate about it. It's going to be quick. We're not going to go.
No, quick. I mean, my.
Do you have strong opinions?
I'm fine with it. Like.
Okay.
Like, the thing is, because, like, these niggas that are complaining should not be losing to someone. If you've been playing on the same controller, right? Fucking 18, 17 years, whatever. And you lose to a nigga who picked up Smashbox in, like, I don't know, 2 days? That's your fault. Like, that's your fault. And if it's that easy, then why don't you pick up a Smashbox? You know what I mean? Like, what the fuck? Like, it's not like they're introducing a new character or something that can't be beat. Like, Smashbox is interesting in itself, but I don't think it's like by any means is it broken. But then people are like, "What about controller modding?" And I'm like, "Well, that's I don't know. Now you're going in too deep because like now you're trying to say like they're controller modding to me is like adding turbos or you know like turbo to your buttons and shit like that. Like and like I don't think that's that big of a deal. You know, some people take their springs out and like I don't think that's big of a deal either. But yeah, maybe that's just me.
But then aren't you changing the holy sanctity of how Melee is played? Like. Let's say you introduce the Smashbox, shit is easier, and the game becomes, you know, 10 times easier to do technical stuff, and everybody picks up a Smashbox, and the game progresses to a different level. Don't you think magic that we had?
Would that be great for Melee, though?
I mean, you could think of it that way. You could think of it as losing, you know, the magic that we had where the tech skill barrier was so difficult that that's what got everybody to love the game. Because that's what a lot of people are playing for, is because there's always a way to improve. People have said that the final boss, I forget whose tweet this was, but the final boss of Melee is yourself. Like, how far you're willing to push yourself. If you'll fuck your hands up for the rest of your life, like, will you make that sacrifice? I'm not saying I'm for or against your argument. I'm just saying like both sides are, you know, people are.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely understand both sides. I just most people that are complaining are people who, I feel like this is what happens usually. Most people that are complaining are people who either already lost to the Smashbox, will never lose to the Smashbox, or don't even fucking play this game. So, like that's where I'm always like I hate when we bring it up to a public vote because people just want to have a fucking opinion without actually. Trying or using or it really existing in the community, you know? So, I mean, at the very least, I mean, I'll have a more educated and informed opinion because I actually fucking play Melee. So, yeah. But I don't know.
Phil, what were you going to say?
I was going to say, I mean, you know, I'm listening to what you guys have to say. I'm pretty uneducated about the whole thing. If I was to give, like, some slight input, doesn't seem like a big deal to me. I mean, I would have to say you'd have to monitor somebody's, like, or track their progress who's just using Smashbox to see if it's really, like, that much of a game changer, but I don't think it's that big of a deal.
Yeah, if someone goes from, like, never getting out of pools to somehow making top 8 after using Smashbox, I would have to question what's going on with that box.
Yeah, but then you got to be like, okay, so you dedicated yourself to this controller, you wanted to be the guinea pig, the first person to try this out, you got really good at it, you tried really hard, fuck you, we're taking it away. That's not right. You gonna do that?
I mean, I was talking about what if it was, like, instant, though.
It's not gonna be instant. Melee is.
But what if it was, like literally, like...
What if it took years? What if it
took years? Alright, well, if it took years, I'm not gonna say shit. Maybe practice. But if this dude, like he goes to a weekly, I mean, goes 0-2, and then he comes to the next weekly with the Smashbox, and go and gets top 8, and then he comes to the next weekly after that and gets first, I'm believing it has something to do with that fucking controller. Ain't nobody improving like that over no drastic period of time. If you've been playing this game for this long with the GameCube controller, going 0-2 every time, and then you finally switch controllers, and now you're like, somehow God, like, it has to be something with that.
That's when it becomes a magic box.
The magic stick. Yeah. Anybody that is asking what Smashbox is, I realized that I should have said what this was. Smashbox, what it is, so the GameCube controller, I don't have one next to me, but I have this PS4 controller. Looks like this, normal controller. Smashbox looks like a fighting game controller, so it's like a box with the digital stick and buttons all over the place. Doesn't really make sense when you first look at it for Melee, but people say that it does work, you just have to get attuned to it. It's more ergonomically designed, because the problem is if you play Melee like this, it's going to fuck up your hands eventually, because it's super technical and your hands are going all over the place and you're going to get bonitis. You're going to get a case of the Neo hand. So you want to get the Smashbox if you're worried about that, because that's a growing concern. There are issues, though, because whereas, like, this is an analog stick, so it takes varying levels of person input, because you can go, you know, gently, you can go hard, whatever. This is digital, so it's either left or not. It's binary. So the inputs are different. They're simplified for some things and harder for other things. So it creates this schism in the game where it's like, okay, do you use this or do you use that? And some people don't want that. They want a unified approach to the game. So there are arguments on both sides. I think Gimmer says that he wants the box. Blur is vehemently against it. So I don't know. It'll shake out in the wash eventually. But yeah, that's a thing going on right now. So I don't have much of an opinion because I don't play Melee, so I don't feel like I should tell people what to do. But seems like everybody else has an opinion. All right. So, let's get to these questions. Go ahead and hit us up, hashtag BlastZone. Ask us any question you guys want. Please make it Smash related. Come on. We will answer all of them. Whether it be Smash, commentary, characters, metagame, anything you guys want. Let's talk about it. So
I need a thinking emoji emote, like, I thought I know there is one, but, like, how the fuck do you do it?
You could just do a thinking emoji. Can I get some thinking emojis in the chat? I know you guys can do that.
Is that only if you're on your phone? Because, like, what if you're not on your phone?
You can do it anyway. I don't know how people do it. I've seen people do it all the time. Chat, hit me up. Throw it up.
What emoji?
There it is. Boom. Joe Star. Ugor. There it is.
It's just a BTTV? Oh, word.
There you go. And, yeah, I don't play any Smash. You're right. I'm a PC guy. Wait till Smash for PC comes out. Wave Dash Games, like,
oh, Franker Face, out. Yeah.
Is it FMC? I don't have FMC. It's gotta be BTTV. Yeah, it's BTTV. Get BTTV!
I have BTTV. Who doesn't?
Not you. Well, I'm telling the chat. If you can't see what these people are doing, get better than Twitch TV. Alright, let's talk. Questions. Scruffle. What? This fucking picture, Scruffle? What type of mod should be allowed in tournaments? Obviously not gameplay changing. None.
I mean, I would like...
Maybe music.
I would like probably just music. But then again, some of y'all have some lame-ass music choices, so I would hate to get on to, like, FD and somehow fucking, like, Slayer's or some shit because you're, like, a metalhead, and I'm like, look, I can't play this shit. Like, so Honestly, I'm okay with none. Most people's like I would be okay with a couple of like competitive like color changes, like, especially for Cloud, like, you know, give him like a better green, a better red, and all that shit. But then the people start to get wild with their shit too. That's the reason why I haven't downloaded a Nairo's mod pack, because this shit is wild. Nairo's mod pack is actually wild. There's mad shit in there that doesn't need to be in there. But everyone else loves it, so it's good for him. But like, I can't do that.
Yeah. I only music, and even then, have discretion. You guys remember when Seagull had Linkin Park on every stage? Like, literally every stage in Brawl, Seagull had at least one Linkin Park song. That was something. You went through the whole discography.
Yeah, I remember that. That was terrible.
Alright, Card SD says, are any of you guys going to MomoCon?
Maybe. I like MomoCon, it was cool.
Okay. There's your answer.
What is this emo combo?
I looked at that too. He was like focusing too. He wasn't listening. Okay. He was just like focusing super hard on making that.
Okay.
Jesus Christ. Alright. Roger Sierra, are you guys going to try to venture into other games to commentate? You guys have been talking about this for a while, right?
At least he can. Venture into other games?
Yeah. Commentating other stuff.
Yeah, we just don't know how.
Yeah.
Like, that's pretty much it. Like, I mean, I'm sure me and E could do a bunch of other games, especially these, like, free-form games that, like, really don't require you to learn too much.
Yeah.
Rocket League seems like a perfect example of something that me and him could do just like that.
Mm.
But, I don't know where Rocket League tournaments are. I don't know who to contact. I also believe that because it's MLG Puckett and and Benson, they usually get those. They're usually getting like their own, or they usually get those spots, you know. So, and they're good commentators too. So I'm not gonna take anything away from them, but
yeah.
I just never see that opening where we can get to another game. I tried very much so to try to do Pokken, and then Pokken died in this state in three weeks. So, you know, what do I do after that? If they don't hire me for the Pokken tournaments that they officially throw, then it's not like I can just keep working myself as a commentator in there.
I got you.
So.
Yeah.
I used to commentate Yu-Gi-Oh! Too, man. Used to.
Hmm?
Used to.
True. All right. Chief the Gamer, what's the cheekiest fox color? Yellow jacket.
Cheekiest or cheeks?
He said cheekiest. Oh, okay. I guess cheekiest. Like bad?
If it's cheekiest, yes, it's definitely yellow.
Hold on, let me look. I just searched fox colors. I'm an idiot. Smash Bros. Fox. It's gonna be some kind of weird search. Don't go to the images section. Alright, fox. Where is his color? Here we go. Alright. I don't like the black jacket. Ooh, but that red scarf is nice. Never mind. Yellow. Well, I don't know. Fox has good colors.
Yeah, but yellow is probably his worst.
Orange. No, because the blue scarf looks nice. Ugh. It's probably yellow. Yeah. Because they had the complementary colors, really. Fox has good-ass colors, man.
Fox has some good-ass colors.
Falco, too. They really tried with them. All right.
Yeah, well, they didn't try with them when they were they didn't try with Falco when they were thinking about, you know, how he's going to play.
Making a good character.
Fuck.
Yeah. Wordchamp says, who's at MAGFest, though?
I'll be at MAGFest.
I think
we'll all be at MAGFest, right?
Yeah, I think we've got a VG panel, right?
Well, we don't know that yet.
We'll know soon enough.
Whoops. Okay. Well, maybe.
Wait, did you already find out? Because I didn't find out.
I don't know anything.
All I saw
have no idea.
Was Tito going getting popping off about him getting a
Pokemon
panel.
Let's go, Tito.
I'm happy for him, but like I never even knew that he was that much into Pokemon. So like, if he's not, this is gonna go terribly. But if he is, then I'm about to be pleasantly surprised.
Well, since I've known Tito, he's been a Pokemon fan, so he's pretty genuine.
No, I'm not saying that like he's not a fan. I just don't know. Like, I don't know what type of panel is he holding. Is he trying to talk about competitive?
Mm.
I've never seen this man talk about competitive anything.
He has a podcast.
Really?
Yeah, he has like a what's it called? He has a
You don't remember he tagged us in
Oh wait, no, I remember.
He asked us to retweet.
Got it. He's right. No, Tito's right. I mean, he's right. He definitely did that podcast with
PK Sparks.
PK, yeah.
Yeah. Jello Hot Dog, thank you for the 3-month subscribe. Thank you for letting me play in your room that one night. That was playing Smash in your room. Thank you for letting me play Smash in your room.
There you go, because I have a name like that, man.
Stop it. That's actually disgusting, Jello Hot Dog. It's awful. All right, I'm going to be at MAGFest too. Everybody's going to be at MAGFest. I'm just driving. You guys have a room, right?
I'm about to just kind of slam my way through. Nah. I have a room with Tito, but like I don't really plan to be in the room. I just need a place to shower and put my shit, basically.
Yeah.
So he was like, "Do you need a place to shower, put your shit, and jam it?" I was like, "Don't you have like 5 people in your room?" And he's like, "Yeah." And I was like, "I'm probably not jamming in your room." So. He's like, "I mean, you can just put on the latch." I was like, "Yeah, but like I didn't like it's not my room, so."
On the latch. That solves everything.
If it's my room, then I'm about jamming it, you know. But like if it's not my room, or at least like they didn't buy the room for me, and like I'm like just in someone's room for their good graces, then I'm not gonna be like, yo, I'm about to. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I got you. Brady says, "Where my bounce house at? It's in the mail. It's coming soon." Soda, which two competitors would you guys like to see face each other that haven't faced before? Example, Leo versus Mr. E. Ooh, that'd be fun. I don't want to say, because I feel like it's probably already happened if I have one. Like, it's so hard to think of.
Who?
Do you guys have any? I don't have one off the top of my head. I'm just saying.
I want to see T versus any top player so niggas can stop talking about this Link. Like, that's all. Like, this nigga needs to win a lot. He needs to win a lot for me to be like, all right, because I don't know if y'all saw my last tier list. But Link was with Nas, but then everyone's like, but what about? And I'm like, but how many tournaments have they won? It's like, all right, you got it. So, you know, I don't care about how often Link do well. Sometimes, like, I need a Link to go and win a top, like a fucking national.
Yeah.
For me to, all right, yeah, now I'll put him in the maybes.
Yeah.
Shadow Stormer X actually named mine. I was gonna say Leo versus Kamehameha. I really want to see that happen.
Really?
It's Kamehameha.
Kamehameha.
The Moosh. Yeah,
Paradin's ready. Paradin's on standby.
a lot of people are saying Leo versus Renai. I think that's a good ass one too.
Yeah, that would be good.
Yeah.
I think an in practice Renai would 3-0 him, but that's just my opinion.
Yeah, I think so too. I think we talked about this actually. Leo and Renai. I think we're pretty sure that we said like Renai in his prime would win. Leo probably right now would win. So, anyway, Sam McClure, what do you think of the presence of player mics during stage picks between matches? This was at Showdown. I really didn't like it. I like the idea of it, but I think it could have been handled better.
It would have been good if they stopped talking when these niggas were doing it.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, like we need to handle it better because I had the commentators and the players talking at the same time. Like. In League, what they do is the commentators talk and they're like, okay, let's listen in. The problem with that is that the time that people are talking in Smash is immediately after a game because you're like, what do you ban? Blah, blah, blah. You have this back and forth. So the commentators need a way to swiftly transition. Okay, and there's the kill move. Let's see what they have to say about this next match. See if there's any emotions coming out of the player. Like, the commentators need to be, like, on that. And so does the production. I think it's a great idea, Sage, if you're watching this. I love you. I think it's a really good idea, and I think it could be explored better, but it's got to be done right. That's all.
What are we talking about? What has to be done?
At Battle Royale, they had player mics. So when it was off for most of the game, but when the game was over, they would hit them on so you could hear the players like talking to each other and like, I ban this, I ban that, whatever, saying like it's a way of like hearing what the players are talking about. I think it's a good idea.
I don't know if I like that idea.
I think it could be explored.
Yeah, I mean, it probably could be explored, but I feel like that really is just the time that cuts where the commentators will be talking about the fucking match. Like, so, like, what do you want to hear more? Like, the slight little bit of analysis that the commentators are going to be able to give right at the end of the match, or, hey, man, what do you ban?
Yeah.
I don't know, man. Like, for me, as a spectator, I don't think I would care too much about that. Like, I can find out. I can make great guesses on what they banned. Simply by what stage we went to, or just knowing their fucking their history.
Thought process.
I got player racial slurs, like yeah, and then you definitely have those fucking like you. I've seen Nairo just mouth shit like he loses.
Yeah.
Fucking bullshit. And I'm like, oh.
Yeah, Nairo does that a lot actually.
Oh yeah, man. I could just yeah. I mean, You ain't like, see, you like, let's cut on this player. Let's cut on this player sound. See what they, hey, nigga, you ain't shit, boy. What you playing? All right, what? Well, that right back off. Like,
that's like only K9's mic. Like, you can't give K9 a mic. He talks the most shit.
All right. Oh my god, that shit would be so funny.
That'd be so good.
Like, you cut on the mic. Fuck out of here, Con. All right, let's go. cut that shit out.
Stay down. I'm the king of smack.
We're not ready for that.
Oh man.
I think it's a good idea. It just needs to be explored. PJ, question for T. I'm gonna let this rock. You can make of this what you will.
Okay.
PJ, question for TK. I'm a bit worried about entering the Smash community as a gay man. What should I look out for?
I don't know why
he's asking you.
I don't know if that's me, but nothing. Like, honestly, man, like, I think the Smash community is kind of one of the more accepting communities as far as sexuality goes. I mean, we got all kind of transgenders and gays and lesbians and all that good stuff. And if you get shit, I mean, it's probably the same shit that you would get just out in the world. And I'm saying it's like, it's good. I'm not saying that you deserve it, but, you know, like, it's not like it's gonna, you're going to be coming to the Smash community, you're going to be magnified hate for being gay. Like, one of our favorite top commentators is gay. Prog is gay, and that man is put everywhere. And if you don't like him, then, like, what are you doing? Well, fuck you, man. Like,
damn, right?
Yeah,
that's real shit.
I'm pretty sure this was a joke question, but I wanted to use it anyway. Like, there's plenty of gay top players. There's plenty of gay commentators. There's plenty of gay people all over the
scene. I agree. Like, never let that discourage you, at least from our community. You know, Twitch chat's a little wild sometimes, but that's any community. Don't worry about it.
We don't even read the chat.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's true.
Real Smash shit. Like, if you, it don't matter if you like dicks or clits. It's what you do on the sticks. You feel me? Quote that shit. Go with it. Do you.
Slam poetry.
That wasn't slam poetry.
Yeah, what?
That was
clits or
clits or
it doesn't
dick.
Matter.
It doesn't matter what you're saying.
It's all about the sticks, man.
That's nice.
Free your mind. Take that girl or boy out the bind. If you
Sam McClure has
if
a,
you bump or grind. Like, all right, calm down.
Sam McClure has a good ass question. Mm. Hold on. I have to prepare myself for this question. Sam McClure wants to know. Do you have any recommendations for quality headsets I could get for under $50? Let me tell you something, my friend. Yes, I do. Boom! There it is, right there! The HyperX Cloud Stinger! Click the banner below the stream and buy now. Best gaming headset you can buy for under $50. Buy it now! Buy it now! There. Buy that shit right now. Good ass question.
All right. Buy that shit.
Yeah. Actually, I do need to put them up. I put them up on my own stream. I need to put their logo up on the Blasphem because they very graciously, for anybody that doesn't know, they partnered with VGBC. Awesome team, those guys. So, yeah. Anyway, check those out if you're looking for a Christmas gift for anybody or if you want to pick something up for yourself. All right. Sumugu, Zero Saga USA versus the World Crew Battles. Who do each of you guys have? I don't know the rosters. Let me look.
Zero Saga versus the World? Too bad. Yeah,
it's USA versus the World.
Zero Saga versus the World. The entire Zero Saga versus everyone who flew in from not in America. Like, all right.
Yeah.
They probably still win though. Anyway,
yeah,
that's
probably true. Yeah.
I
don't know the entrance. I'm looking.
Yeah, I don't know the roster, but I'm gonna say the World just because I'm a trade now. I'm gonna say USA because I'm wearing American jeans right now. Like,
that's smart.
Or American joggers, but
yeah, I mean the World usually wins. Like U.S. never wins.
I'm feeling good about U.S. man.
All right.
I'm feeling real good about that roster we got. Yeah, it's gonna be some good shit.
Hold on. All right. So Pulse Gaming, Nierat just shared something from Pulse Gaming, which I think is the Frostbite. So this is North America versus Japan. He says, why no Mexican players? Why is North America just a picture of the United States? Where is Hawaii, Alaska? Someone help me. Nierat's memeing all over the place. So this is for the North America versus Japan crew battle at Frostbite, which I think is going to be a better like example of this. So it's going to be T-Shuton? He's going to shit on people. Kameme, Komorikiri, Abadongo against Zero, Nairo, Ally, Salem, DeBuzz. So really, that just comes down to how good T and Shutan are. Because, like, Kameme, Komurahiri, and Abadango are good. But...
Shu's good.
Yeah, they're good, but my point is, like, T and Shutan, like, we don't know how good they are. Like, I'm sure they're great, but, like, we haven't seen them in a crew battle. They're against Zero, Nairo, Ally, Salem, DeBuzz. It's, like, it's dependent on them. Because everybody on the U.S. side is excellent, obviously. So, that's all. People are saying it's 10v10. Okay, well then we add a bunch more people, including a Greninja named Sum. Damn. Alright. Anyway, that event's gonna happen. We can talk about it more when it happens. It's good. That's a wild question. Is DK yelling at somebody in the chat?
Nah, because when someone said, who was the gay commentary, I said Prague. I was like, Prague's the only gay commentary I know by knowledge, which I was really going to go into. I think Shippo might also be at some point in time something.
Come on, man. But, he's a commentator.
But then everyone was like, Sky? And I was like, oh, wait, so Sky commentates one thing, now he's a commentator, so I just put you got it a bunch of times.
Oh, that's what that was.
Yeah, like, oh, yeah, man. Sky, too. Yeah, Sky, sure. Sky's a commentator. Yeah, whatever. Yeah.
All right, SN says, thoughts on Pikachu? He's all right. He's okay.
Pikachu's probably like top 15.
Yeah.
He's okay. Yeah, Pikachu's good.
Hard to play. Devin Bayman, who do you think is the second best player? I don't think we can't say. Zero is clearly the best. Second best is whoever's.
There is no second best. Shut up. Stop asking this question, okay? Yeah, like, this
come
question.
Come on, man. Let him ask.
No, this you. Question. So who is the second best and who are the five gods of Smash 4 do not exist. That is not a question that can be answered. There's 6 second best. There is 19 five gods. There's no point in trying to answer that question because regardless of what you say, someone is going to disagree with you because none of that shit is factual. Like, ever. Like, at some point in time, the second best was Nairo and then it wasn't. And then it was Ally and then it wasn't. And then it was Anti for one fucking tournament and then it wasn't. So, like, just stop. Like, it's not a good question. The best is Zero and that's that. It's a scramble for who can make second place under Zero consistently, and that almost is never an answer that works. Like, there is no literal fucking gods. Zero's the best. Everyone else is really fucking good, and then after that, that's it.
Yep.
There is no gods. There will not be any gods. I don't know what's the point of people trying to get gods so quick. Gods wasn't even a term used in Melee until, like, about 4 years ago.
Years and years.
Now, we've had this game for, like, 2 years, and everyone's like, well, gods, we need them. No, we don't. No, we don't. We know who's good. We know who's bad. That's all that matters.
Yeah, y'all niggas need to stop saying Leo is second best. My nigga, what did Leo get at UGC when he was put to
Leo got fucking bopped.
With a tournament with that many top players there? He lost to average players. Being not average. Like, Mars is not average. But Darkshad, until that tournament, I would say he was considered pretty average. But Darkshad's definitely been on the come up. So good shit to him. But y'all got to stop. Can Leo win a major first? Can he win a U.S. Can I get a Leo win at 2GG? Can I get a Leo win at Genesis? Not a fifth
something,
place.
Something big with a lot of top
not players. Not a Canada Cup. You know what and I mean? His, not a Smash Factor.
His hardest match at Canada Cup actually started in Grand Finals. Like, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, you like,
get the fuck out of here. Yeah, I mean, like, everyone, what about Mewtwo King? No. We all knew he was going to beat Mewtwo King. Like, we were literally banking on if fucking Ally was going to do it or not, and he did not, so.
Yeah. Kind of as a side note, Darkshad's gameplay, that if more people played Ryu, like, I genuinely think people would think that, like, it would be, like, the Bayonetta thing all over again. That character's fucking obnoxious. Like, he just does this, and if he hits it, he kills you. Like,
that he was actually, that shit was so funny, because, like, by the last round, all he literally was doing was landing with an aerial and 3 up tilts.
Yep.
And if any of it connected, he was back in.
That character is wild.
Oh.
Good lord. If there were more Ryus, we would have to have a discussion. Like, I don't know. That's just good lord.
Leo will win Zero Saga or Genesis 4, one of those. Watch. Yeah, okay.
Okay.
If he does, good for him, but you're not proving me wrong.
I'm gonna gazo that shit right now.
Like, there I would, if he wins that, then good for him, because it's not like I'm rooting against him. I'm just telling you niggas to shut the fuck up with this, like pretty outdated knowledge. You just one dude comes out of nowhere and starts winning shit, and then immediately you want to, like, give him these, like, accolades for no fucking reason. Like, that's what I don't like.
He hasn't won it, and the problem I have with it is he hasn't won a national yet. Yep. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, he has not won a national. When we look at players who we want to put as the best, we look at Ally, Nairo, and Zero, because they won national.
Yeah.
Leo came out and did, You know, like, he did that little call out, and that's where his fame started. Oh, yeah, like, let Zero come down here. I beat him, but I can't come to America. So then he starts coming to America, and then he starts getting his ass handed to him by fucking Zero. And no one wants to acknowledge that, though. No one's talking about that. No one's talking about, like, wow, this guy was talking all this shit, and he still hasn't taken a set off Zero.
Yeah.
But he the second best, though, because he beats everyone else but loses to Dark Shad. Okay.
No.
All right, man. Y'all got it.
He's super good, but second best is not yet. Not yet. We'll talk more maybe after 2GG. Cinema Johnson says, do Melee fans not realize that other fighting games have fight sticks and pads? Are they just stuck in their ways? Kind of. Like, you gotta understand the context, though. Like, Melee grew out of, like, the earth. Like, it grew out of the ground. There was never any intent for it to be competitive. So, like, the GameCube controller is deeply rooted in Smash history. And, like, to take that away, like, you can't really do that without a lot of discussion. I think people are more attached to it than they normally would be. So I don't think it's that simple, but I hear what you're saying. It's you had to have been around for it, really, to make sense of it. So, Submediant, whose name on Twitter is Alolan D1, which is actually... That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Submediant says, what little tips and tricks do you guys have for someone traveling out of state to a tournament for this for the first time? Are you doing that, Submediant? Hope you do. Dude, it's good. Traveling out of state to a tournament for the first time. Tips and tricks. The problem is we've done it so much that, like, I'm trying to know your pools beforehand. Always know your pools and where you have to be at the right time. Know where, who the best person in your pool is. Study up the people in your pools. There's got to be YouTube videos of them all everywhere, so you can look them up. You guys have any input?
Of going to your first, what, national?
First out-of-state tournament. Traveling out-of-state. I don't know, because we've done it so much. I have a hard time, like...
Yeah. I mean, we don't play anymore, though, so it's different for us. Like, the last tournament I entered that was out of state was Shine. Somehow got 17th there. that was fun. Mm-hmm. But other than that, I mean, I really haven't. I don't really look up anyone. I don't look up anyone because I don't respect anyone. Real shit. And, like, as a commentator, if I don't know your name, I feel like I should be beating you. So, like, and that's basically what happened. The only people I lost to were the people that I already knew. So, I was like, all right, cool. But all these other people, like, I never get scared of anyone. I see a character, and I'm like, all right, you about to play like this, and then I'm going to beat it. And then, so if you don't know someone's name, just be disrespectful about it. Don't play disrespectful, just be disrespectful about it. You don't know this nigga, you should beat him. And if you do know the name, then yeah, do what Cody said and look him up.
Yeah.
Yeah, and make sure you have housing.
Yeah, that too.
I see that way too often. That's way too overlooked. Niggas going to events and don't have a place to stay. Don't let it be you.
Yeah. Seems like a smart guy, so I didn't think of that, but I guess we should say that because that's like a broad question. Don't be stupid. Like, if you're traveling out of state, you need a place to stay, you idiot.
Yeah, don't do that. Don't do that Music King shit. Just show up and be like, hey, man, stay in your room. If Music King's been doing that shit, even with sponsors. That's what's killing me. I'm like, can't you just make a phone call? Like, hey, I need a room for tonight. Oh yeah, maybe got you. Nah.
Jeez.
That's too hard.
Alright,
let me just stay in your room.
Raycat Rakitra, Smashbox interests me. If it's digital only, the Firefox angles are being divided by number of buttons. That's pretty cool. I mean, there are a lot of things that changes. I don't know if it's digital only. I couldn't tell you. I think so, but yeah, that does make sense. In the video for Smashbox, they had a video of Firefox going at all angles, and that was one of the points they pointed out. So it's not only the 8-way. So that was kind of surprising.
But you can do that anyway, though.
Yeah, but my point is, you can do it on the Smashbox, which, like, digital inputs being, if you only have 8 ways, like, you couldn't do a Firefox, like, at the exact angle you want it, because.
But you can do that on the Smashbox.
Yes.
Or you can't do that on Smashbox. Oh.
That's one of the things that they made a point about.
But I feel like you could also do that on a controller. You just have to hold it in between the notches.
That's the point. It's easy on a controller. It would theoretically not work on a Smashbox, but they're showing that it can.
Okay. All right.
Anyway. Dummy. George says...
I don't know what you're talking about. Anyway.
George says, in your opinion, who? Oh, dude. Well, all right. We just talked about this, so he didn't. He asked this question before. George said, in your opinion, who's your top 10 best players as of right now?
Next.
Top 5 at the same time. Zero, number 1. That's it.
Next.
Zero, one.
Answering those questions. You need better questions than that, because honestly, your opinion questions always start off with you disagreeing with my opinion regardless, as if your opinion is law. So let's just not do that. Next.
I can name question. Any 5 players, and I guarantee the next tweet would be, no X, no...
Yep.
Do not get me with that shit. No.
No.
All right.
That's hot. That's dope. Yo, why don't we have? Can we? That needs
we
to be.
Need a, we need a soundboard. For
someone that? Make the BTT emote of just the like the fucking word bubble that says that's dope inside, and just put a dope, and we'll me and Tony will both use it because like I need it.
Do that.
I need it.
All right, Oscar Lovage, what rank do you think John Numbers deserves to be on the PGR V2 with multiple wins on 6WS?
Next, man.
Can't give you an exact number, but he's going to go up. There, done.
Wait, are we? Do you want an exact number of the PGR top 100? 100 people, and you expect people to not disagree with me by throwing out any number?
Son.
Next!
76.
His name is Adblock for life, too. Can you not do that?
That's probably the dude that walked up to me and told me he was using Adblock at a big house. Fuck that guy, man.
All right.
I don't even run commercials like that, so it doesn't even matter. But, like, just for him to think he was getting under my skin for that, like, get the fuck out of here, man.
Yeah. Mock Christmas. Characters you feel are going to rise and fall on the tier list as Smash 4 advances. I'll give you one of each. That's it. Ness is going to fall. Ness is only going to fall. I think Mario's going to fall. I think it hasn't happened yet. I think Mario has Ness syndrome, just not as bad. Who's going to rise?
If Fox already hasn't risen, he's about to.
Yeah, Fox was the first one that came to my mind, too.
And maybe Peach. But it wouldn't be by, like, a lot. She's not going to, like, rise from being, like, mid-tier to high-tier.
Like, three spots.
Two, three spots, yeah.
I feel you, yeah. Yeah. You have any thoughts on that?
Yeah, what y'all said was right.
Got it, okay. All right, Cinemod, I see Tekken commentators getting flown to Japan and back. Is Smash too negative of a scene for stuff like that to happen? No, I think it's just Namco pays for them.
Their company cares.
Yeah.
All right, so this is the other thing we need to get into. All right, so all the things that people complain about for commentary and all this good shit is shit that we, like really can't fix without having more money. And because Nintendo is not one of those companies that supports their game in the way that Namco, Capcom does, you know, there is no commentary workshop. There is no production workshop. There's none of that shit. Like, we just have to go with... We have to do the best we can with what we got, with what money is provided from other outside companies, like Avid, who I don't even know if they're still doing a thing. Avid, UGC had a lot of money behind them. Ult had a lot of money behind them. So all the shit that, like, would make production better comes straight from their pocket.
Right.
The stuff that makes production better for other games, other esports, is actually the fucking company promoting their own game. And, like, because we don't have that, we are far behind. But, like, everyone just somehow fucking forgets that. Like, every time we have this conversation, I'm like, yo, that's not, like, that's, like, not how it is. You know what I mean? Like, that's, I mean, like, if you're going to go ahead and discredit the fact that we've come this far with the tools that we got, then, like, so be it. But at least be reasonable about it. And understand that, like, yo, we do not have the money that will help us do shit such as having commentator workshops, you know, having production workshops. This, like, getting an all-around, like, overhaul of how production should be. We're just not going to have that. Like,
That's all.
Commentary is pretty much bred by us, for us. So, FUBU, nigga. Like, FUBU commentary, yo. But, yeah, now, like, commentary for Smash will always be like that. It's very freeform for that exact reason, because we haven't had anyone to really reel it in or anyone to really show us what to do. We just have seen other sports and, like, we need to do this more. But at the same time, we still want to be ourselves, and that's, yeah, I'm okay with it.
That's why you have so many people, like, arguing about what Smash commentary should be. You got people, like, yeah, and I compared it in a tweet to, like, Hogwarts, like, sorting houses, where you have some people that are like, oh, this should be super analytical and play-by-play, and some people say it should be totally esports, and some people say, no, just keep it grassroots with cursing. Like, there are all these different ideas of what Smash commentary should be. There's no accepted standard.
Well, I think the thing that I dislike about, like, some people's, like, take on commentary, like, I think commentary for anything should be entertaining, right? Mm-hmm. And it should always be informative too, but it doesn't have to be informative in the aspect of like breakdown, like, you know, why did this happen on frame or what frame this came, you know what I'm saying? That frame over analytical bullshit. I don't think you need that. Like, I always approach it like, I want to tell a story. I want you to be invested in the match, be interested, and be excited for the outcome, right? I'm not fucking interested in telling you, you know, what frame something came out. I don't give a fuck, to be honest. I never will care.
The frame data and just like, always boring analysis and meta and why shit works. It's boring. Like, to be completely honest, I do not, I really do not like analytic commentary for Smash 4 unless it's a spot where it's an unusual event that happens. Or it's a very dry spot in the match where you can then break down some of the shit that happened before. Yeah. But like for these people that just live to see something and then analyze the very like essence of that, like one jab hits and you want to analyze why that jab hit over all the scenarios or why that jab wouldn't hit, I don't care about that shit. Like the jab hit, tell me the jab hit and then keep it moving. Like, you know what I mean?
What position did that put him in? You know what I mean? Like, why is that detrimental to him? Not why the fuck did that hit? You know what I mean? Like, get that shit out of here. And that's why, like, when somebody makes a comment, like, I respect everyone's opinion, but, like, when JV makes a comment, like, everyone...
Oh, whoa, hey, with your name!
I'm not saying anything negative. Like I said, I like JV. I respect his opinion. But who says the commentator, a comment like, everyone is trash? Homie, put yourself in whatever category you hold yourself to. I feel like all of us as commentators have come a long way from where we once started out of. Is it still perfect? Hell no. I will agree with that.
Well,
is everyone trash? Hell no, my man. That's just simply not true.
He did put himself in there, though.
Yeah, I know he did. And again, that's why I'm respecting that. And I'm saying, okay, I get that. But I'm saying, like, I don't agree with that saying everyone is trash by any means. Like, I understand you have where you think it should be, and that's cool. But saying everyone is trash discredits the work that actually legitimately we have put in to, like, improve our craft and, like, the money we put out of our pockets to go to these events to commentate for an opportunity to present a good product. So I didn't like that at all. But,
yeah, we put a lot of fucking money in
this. We will all continue to grow.
I don't think I've made... So. I actually don't even think I've broken even yet by the amount of money that I put into go to commentate all this shit to the amount of money that I'm now not putting in. I'm still putting in money, though. Like, you know, like, this, everything's not catered for us. Like, we get a flight, we get a hotel, and sometimes we get $500, sometimes we get $200, like, 6 weeks later. But from the money that I used to have to put in, like, for this, and, you know, that I still sometimes have to put in, yeah, there's no way I broke even. I did 6 to 8 years of flying myself out, getting my own hotel, splitting it with friends, not getting paid for commentary, buying my own food all the time, coming home, taking that hit to my bank, and then finally in the last 2 years, I'm starting to understand the importance of commentary and flying us out and doing all that shit. And even then, they're still barely doing that, you know? Like, it's a hassle to get a flight out here, man. It's a hassle to talk to these people, and it's like, and I'm okay with it because, like, I understand, like, we're all broke. Like, in the end of the day, we're all broke. Smash community does not have that much money. So, like, when I hit somebody up and they're like, we can't fly you out, I'm like, all right, cool. Then I try to see if there's other ways I can get out there, and if I can get out there, I just can't. But even then, we get the lowest form of flight. Like, we get that $200, you in the back of coach flight.
Yo, every one of those trips, my nigga, I was by the engine.
Yeah.
It was singing to me.
And kind of going off what TK said, like, I played Smash since 2010. I've still made more money playing League of Legends when I used to boost accounts than I ever have in Smash. I'm pretty sure that, like... I think I'm positive in both because I had a time where I was winning a lot of tournaments in Smash, but in League I made so much more money. The money in Smash is not, like, if you come into this for money, it's not happening. So
I'm surprisingly positive in Smash 4. I haven't really put much money into.
You haven't entered, like, with the pots and shit.
Yeah. So, but like I made 7th and fifth enough times to get paid out. So and also 2nd in dubs a lot. So I made like $400 over the time in Smash 4 as far as playing. And then I was positive in minus because we won the tournament.
Yeah, we did it.
I entered two minus tournaments. I got 3rd in 1 and 1st in the other. So
whoa, hold on, Joe. You've made more money off Smash than League. Do you not boost? Okay, sorry. Awful is in the chat. He's a really good League player, and he was an okay Smash player. But apparently, he's won more from Smash than League. That blows my mind. Like, I guess locals are powerful. Damn, good shit. All right, let me see. Connor says, thoughts about SDIing out of Mewtwo's up smash. Dude, That was crazy.
How did he do that
shit? I still don't.
I'm still trying to figure out how he did that shit. Yeah. I never asked him. I should have asked him if he did it on purpose. Cause like I've seen people fall out of YouTube's Up Smash before, but like in the way that he did it, it looked like he actually wanted that to happen.
Yeah, it looked intentional.
That was crazy.
I too am curious about that. That's a good question. We need to follow up with Isam about.
As well, Card SD. Do you guys see Rivals of Aether taking off once it fully releases? Think Genesis 4 and COD Dreamland will help it go? Could it return to Xanadu? No. Gonna be real with you.
No.
Not seeing it, man.
I don't know what it is that made so Rivals came out and Brawlhalla came out around decently around the same time. Brawlhalla came out a little earlier. Everyone was like, "This game is all right, but it's not Rivals." Like literally, everyone said that. Yeah. Like everyone you asked them Brawlhalla, it's not Rivals. Rivals comes out, people play it for about a fucking week, and then they're back to doing whatever the hell else they were doing. Yeah. And I don't know why that game didn't stick because everyone like when I first played it, Rivals was one of the funnest games I ever played. And even then, with that, like, me giving it that fucking accolade, it didn't even stick with me. And I still go back and every now and then play Brawlhalla. One of the things I know, it was definitely marketing. Brawlhalla marketed itself a lot easier, and it's also free to play. So, free to play. But they give out a lot of those codes that, you know, the Founders Pack. So you just get all the fucking champions. Anyway, there is none of that for Rivals. Rivals is just, you buy the game, you get everything. Whatever, but it's $14, and for some reason people just don't want to make that like an investment, you know? So
I feel like Rivals, no matter how much I look at it or see it, it still feels like a fan game, and that turns me off. Like I can't get into it because like it feels like a pixel game, and I know it's pixels, and I know it's like it feels like I'm playing a Flash game, and
yeah,
it's a great. I'm sure it's a great game. I'm sure it's a lot of fun, game. But I can't get past this idea that like. And I don't think it's the pixel graphics. I don't think that's the problem. Cause, like,
the graphics, that taken itself was pretty dope. I think that was pretty ballsy. Pretty ballsy and also kind of helped them out as well. So
there's just something that doesn't feel right to me. And maybe it's just me, but, I mean, a bunch of people. Like, I respect all the work that went into it. I just can't, like, I don't know. I can't get into it. That's all. So
I mean, not every game is going to click and stick with everybody.
Right, yeah.
You know, and that just happens to be one of those games for me.
All right, let me see. Tito says, how's it going, Tito? Which event in 2017 are you going to that you are most excited for, the city or venue, more than the actual tournament? For me, CEO, because I want to go to Orlando for a reason that I can't talk about here. I can tell you guys later, but I don't want to say it on stream. It's CEO, though. How about you guys?
Before you about to, what you about to do it? My nigga about to hit this Vice City.
I don't want evidence. I don't want evidence. It's nothing like that. I'm doing something for someone.
All right, cool. Is it Mallory?
Come on, man.
Who the fuck else would it be?
All right, so I don't know why you had to.
I don't know. I just don't.
All right, anyway, man, whatever. Whatever. All right, so check this out. Oh, I got it.
Right there.
Shh, I got it though.
What?
I know what it is. Are you renewing your vows?
No.
Happy anniversary.
Thank you. All right, come on. Keep going. Do you guys have anything? Do you have anything?
Are you going to ask her to marry you again?
What's your favorite? What city do you want to go to?
I am very much so looking forward to... I don't know.
Okay.
Is Evo Japan happening in 2017? When is that again?
Are you gonna get her pregnant at
Orlando? Specifically
in Orlando, like.
Anybody? Yeah, somebody said anywhere but San Jose. No. Genesis 4. I'm not hyped. I'm hyped for the tournament. San Jose is one of the worst venue cities.
San Antonio for PAX South. That looks cool.
Okay, there you go. Smart.
All right, so yeah, actually, January is already stacked. I got Magfest in the first week. Then I got a week off, then Genesis 4, then PAX South. So, yeah, we just... Am I ever going to be home? And I literally just made that tweet saying, I can't live in a world where I don't stream more than 110 hours every
month. And now you're fucked.
I can still do it. It's going to be hard. Yeah. I literally have to stream every day that I'm home, though. So, yeah,
when is MAGFest?
The 5th through the 8th.
Hey, are tickets for PAX South still available?
Fuck.
PAX South?
Yeah.
I mean, you can check. I'm pretty sure I'm getting mine through Discord, so...
I should ask John. Okay. Wait, can you get another ticket?
No. You asked me this already.
I didn't ask you. That was probably PB&J.
Nah, you did. I would have. First of all, PB&J already knows not to ask me, so I know you asked me already.
All right, I'll ask.
Hugo Paulson says, please say la 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 if Coney's Brawl DDD was always better than Koi Teens. That's not true.
It got better, but it wasn't always better.
Yeah, the Brawl DDD crown changed hands. It was Koi Teen, Atomisk, me. No, Koi Teen, Sabric, Atomisk, me, Vex. And Vex was the last one.
Whoa, you forget about my man, Forgod?
Forgod never did it. Forgod was the Sunken King. He almost made it. He could have been the best, but he never did it. He always was close. Shouts to Forgod. Awful nose. Forgod was dope. He was good as shit, but he never got, like, he never made it to that next level. Like, he was always good as shit, but he never did it. All right, Connor says, thoughts on Lucas? Good character.
Yeah, he's pretty good. Next.
Yeah, he's a good character. There you go. Curling W says, oh, here we go. Momocon and Combo Breaker for the same weekend, May 26th through the 28th.
That's bad scheduling on their part.
Hey, what are you looking for?
They all need to get their shit together. But I'll tell you what, I'd much rather go to Hotlanta than the Midwest. So, we'll see what happens.
Hotlanta.
Shit is dope.
Catch you then. So, when we moved, when we moved into the house, apparently this mail came from one of our Mallory's, it's our niece, her friend's daughter, and it has us in our new house, and Aunt Mallory, Uncle Zach.
Aww.
Very cute.
What is that? Is that a little baby?
Did you notice that?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought that was a little baby.
So cute. And you're green.
I am green. That's lovely. How old is she?
She's 5.
That's very cute. It's very
sweet. She's 5 and she's drawing like that, man.
It was opening mail. It was all hidden.
Cool.
It was like,
that's really sweet. Write them and say, I said thank you.
And I'll be like, we didn't get this, Cassie. We're so sorry.
Yeah. Cool. Okay. Love you. All right. Okay, we're back. Sorry. She's backing out. I don't know why she's backing out like that. I don't...
Bye, Mallory.
TK said bye. Okay.
Mallory always seems so unenthused to talk to me.
Damn.
What? I said bye.
He says that you always sound so unenthused to talk to him.
Didn't you like lock Zach out of the room in St. Louis?
No. Where I locked him out of the room. Because he went to bed at like 4 a.m.
Oh.
But he got in.
I thought he locked you out of the room.
No.
Wow, Zach, what are you saying?
I didn't say anything. What, are you trying to get me in trouble? Like, he's the lock, huh?
Molly.
Okay, I love you. Goodbye. All right, I didn't say that.
TK, that's so weird. Remember what I said.
Remember what she said.
Remember what I said about you. All
right, I gotta do a show, honey.
Remember.
You got it. Okay.
Is Mal drunk?
Right. That's what I'm wondering.
I love you.
All right. She said she loves you. All right. Let's back to the show.
Not as my favorite, but. She hates me, man. She's lying. Why does she hate me? No. All right, let's do this. Back to the show.
Good Lord. Okay.
I'm about to check my text in like 10 minutes. I know she's about to.
Oh, you know that. Yeah, she will. She will. Andy Reid, this question is for EE. What are your opinions on King DDD in the current metagame? What the fuck?
These directed questions are killing me.
It can instantly make your question like 10 times funnier. Like,
well, I think DDD, clearly struggles being relevant in the current meta. I think if you want to see the most success with him, you'll find it on 4Glory. I feel like that's actually where DDDs tend to shine. And in the Mario matchup, because I think he wins that match.
Yep, I think so too. Shit's annoying.
So, there you go.
Well, actually, no. I don't think he beats Mario, but I think he...
That's damn good.
Yeah, he spaces people out better than most characters. It's annoying. Cinema Johnson, once more, thoughts on rumors of a new Smash for the Switch? Are there rumors? That's dope. We don't talk about rumors. It'd be cool.
If it's, I feel like it's not new Smash, though. I think it's just like a Smash 4 Definitive Edition, some shit like that. That'd be dope. Like, but like, if they gave a Smash 4 Definitive Edition, like one more fucking patch, maybe like one character, I'd be like, all right.
Yeah. Sam McClure, thoughts on DK and Bowser being characters that only need 3 grabs to kill? Yeah, but they get hit a lot. They're rage monsters.
Yeah, but the more you hit them, the more scary it gets. So.
Yeah. It's a counterpick thing. I think DK and Bowser are going to best be used to, like, counterpick players and playstyles more than, like, be solo viable mains, but, you know, whatever. Thunderdome, is Bowser as dumb as the backlash toward Nairo's set with Mr. E made him out to be? No, Mr. E just wasn't ready for it. That's all it was. Mr. E was playing a different kind of game. He was not playing anti-grab. That's it.
He kept going in.
Yeah.
And with Bowser, you keep going in. Yeah, you keep going in against Bowser. Like, he literally needs 3-4 grabs and you're done.
Yeah. You have to play anti-grab. And the way that you space against Zero Suit is very different from the way you space against Bowser. That's really all it was. He wasn't ready for it. That's it. Same with Zenodo. I think Bowser is just, like, people don't remember how to play against it. That's all. It's 100% anti-grab. That's it. Roger Sierra, who is a player that you would like to see win a big tourney who hasn't won one? I'd like to say Renai. I want to see Mr. R win the fucking major. He hasn't done it yet. I want to see him do it. I don't think he ever will. I hope he does.
I don't know about Mr. R winning a major. Like, I think, like, and of course, you know, we're all good friends with Robin here, but
yeah.
It's weird to me because it's like, I want to see him do it, but it's like, he needs to get close enough. Like, at UGC, he finished in 9th, right?
Yeah.
He didn't even compete in the top 8, so that kind of sucks. That's a blow. But I honestly think with the right bracket, he could do it. He really could do it. Like, I do believe in Ramen to do it, but he needs the right bracket. He needs just, you know, maybe the right amount of 1 or 2 upsets, you know, on his path to that. But I definitely think he can. He is capable of doing it. It's just hard.
I think the perfect Sheik is super hard to play. And, like, he's going to run out of steam faster. And I think he kind of missed the boat, because for a while he was getting second, third.
Like, yeah, he was right on the cusp of winning one.
Those times are over. So.
And then, you know, stuff happened, and it's harder. Especially when people are so well acclimated in the Sheik matchup now. You know what I mean? That's just something you know, like, the back of your hand at this point. So,
exactly.
Which I think is kind of the reason you see him playing, you know, a little more Bayonet, a little more Cloud lately, which I think is good.
Yeah.
For him, like, expand your character pool.
Yeah. Struffle, we already answered the Bowser question. Austin, when are we banning Duck Hunt? You guys want to ban Duck Hunt?
Yeah.
Get that shit out of here.
I hate that stage. I've never seen anyone pick Duck Hunt. With the intent of when it running away, so it's just not fun. Like, you know what a match you're getting into. Like, soon as, like, what happens is, like, once the commentator's cam is on and I'm sitting there like this. As soon as I see Duck Hunt, I just... all right, we're going to be in for a long one, boys.
When someone picks Duck Hunt, it's really just demoralizing, not just to the gameplay, but to the casters, too. It's just like, it's going to be fucking lame.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
yep.
It's just one of those stages. It just takes it out of you.
Will says, any of you guys going to KIT in January? That's the Tennessee one. I forget how to say it, but...
Kids?
Kumite or something like that. Kumite. But regardless, they haven't hit us up, so if they hit us up, I'm about it.
Yep.
That's how we work, man. You hit us up, we'll go. But if you...
Yeah.
You know, the only time I really reach out to a tournament is if it's a tournament that looks so hype and they haven't hit me up. I'm like, all right, man, hold up. Like, that's what we did for Canada Cup. They didn't hit us up. We asked them. I wanted to go out of state, though. Yep. Straight up. I was like, I just got...
Yo, did that nigga ever say anything?
No. I sent him the invoice, and he just, thanks. I'll send it again, man.
Connor Zombie says, who is the 27th best player? According to the Panda Global stats, as of last year, it was K9. I'm going to say, do you think Pug West is too high?
I'm going to say Sam Sora.
That's a good answer.
Sam Sora, oh, I think that's too low.
You think that's 27? Too low?
I think that's too low. Sam Sora, top 20.
Damn.
Sam Sora's good, dude.
And Sam Sora got beat by Dark Shad, though.
He did, but a lot of people got beat by Dark Shad. Dark Shad was on some shit.
Zach? Captain Zack?
Captain Zack 27? That's low.
Yeah. Yeah. Dark Shed?
Smasher 1001.
That's my boy.
Shemans.
Like, there's so many good players, dude. This is hard. All right, we'll see. We'll see. Ask us after Zero Saga. We'll go. All right. Fitz, who's your player to watch in 2017? Captain Zack. That's it for me. Dude's good. There. Why are you laughing?
How quick that answer came out. We were just talking about Captain Zack. Captain Zack, get next.
The real answer is I don't know, because last year I said Tweak, and bless his heart, Tweak is very good. Just hasn't figured out the secret formula yet, so I'm not damning another soul.
My player to watch, that nigga Dark Shad.
That's a good answer.
Coming for heads, man. Don't sleep, man. He'll be like, man, he plays, his mouth is agape. It's because that nigga's taking in information.
He breathes
y'all
it
gonna
in.
See. Y'all gonna see.
George, alright, okay, then how about which players do you want to see more of, ones that don't come out as much? George, I don't know, man. I mean, this is the guy that asked for our top 10 or top 5, now he's asking for what players you want to see more of. Anybody good? Say that.
Yes. Sam, more Icy Mist.
Icy Mist is all I need, man. Icy Mist has been making mad top 8s out of nowhere, so... Good shit, but, you know, Sam Floor too.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Sam's play as Chris.
Fish says, thoughts on the Magic Scrumpy situation. Do you find it sad? Thanks. He said thanks.
What's the Magic Scrumpy situation?
Thank you very much. Okay, so Magic Scrumpy, I don't know the whole drama because YouTube drama is the corniest shit to me, and it kind of felt like that. But apparently, Scrumpy entered a combo contest with a tool-assisted thing. Like, it was supposed to be an actual combo contest, like a combo video contest, and his was tool-assisted. And apparently his, like, How to Make X Viable series that he's been doing on YouTube has been blatantly, like, pulling from SD Remix. Like, Ripple made a post about it, even though he outright condemned SD Remix at some point. He was like, oh, I don't like this project. I don't know enough about it, because I don't follow YouTubers, so I don't know. Maybe it's scummy. I honestly don't know. Maybe the chat can tell you more. I really don't know that much. But entering a combo video contest with a tool-assisted thing, that's shitty. Like, period. But I don't know what to... I don't know what to tell you. I don't know enough about it. Sorry.
Yeah, I don't know enough about it either, so...
But thank you for saying thanks in the tweet. That was sweet of you. Very nice. Avery wants to know... Do you know where I can get a high-quality gaming headset for cheap just in time for the holidays? Do you mean the number one gaming headset available for under $50? HyperX Cloud Stinger. Click the banner below the stream and buy now. Buy now. Buy now. Hit that button. All right. God. That's an assault on the senses when that shit pops up. Ugh. All right, what additions... Connor Zombie says, what additions do you want to see in the next iteration of Smash to evolve the meta? I don't know, dude. Cause
what?
Do you want to see in the next iteration of Smash to evolve the meta? We don't know because we don't know where they're going to take it. If you asked me last game and that they were going to put in a ledge system like the one we have in Smash 4, I wouldn't have known what the fuck that means. I would have been like, yeah. Oh, that doesn't make sense. So, like, we don't know.
Yeah, that's kind of a... Question doesn't really pan out too well. I would like more hits to lead in more hits. Like, that's, I don't think we need necessarily more hits done, but I feel like it would be a lot easier in this game to have at least like one aerial, like more people who have aerials that lead into like the final hit instead of just everything. Like, you can't get a kill unless you have a down throw to
something. Kill confirms.
I would like kill confirms that start with a hit that go into more hits. Like Meta Knight's up air to up B, that's just dope. Like, we need more of those.
Yep.
But
I got you.
All we have is, like, if you don't have a down throw to something, or you don't have a great up smash,
you gotta
like
work just, hard.
Or top 10, sorry.
Yep. All right. Jay says, What? Oh, I see. Jay says, so Street Fighter just hit the White House. Where's the dopest place you could be invited to commentate a blowout set?
The White House?
You think that's the best place? I feel like you could go to...
Maybe not next year, but...
I'm trying to go to the fucking Taj Mahal. Like,
dude, I was about to say the Taj Mahal! That's crazy! That's actually crazy.
That's the answer.
Yeah, I was going to say the Taj Mahal, too. That's fucking nuts.
That's a good-ass answer, dog. Yeah, any wonder of the world. Like, any of that shit. I'm trying to think of other ones. Space Needle? No, not really. Because, like, it's all inside. Taj Mahal is the only answer, I think. Sphinx?
Oh, Sphinx is actually a good answer, too.
Yeah.
Oh, Eiffel Tower would be fun.
Yeah.
A top there. Or the Leaning Tower of Pizza. That'd be timing people out
in Big Ben. Holy shit. Oh, that's good. All right. the space station. Oh, that's
yo, good. Let's
Mars.
Do it.
Oh, my God.
I don't think I'd get through the training, though.
8 months of astronaut training to cast a set. Coke says, with the release on... This is on Mechanic Coke. With the release of Smash 4 on the Switch with added content, how hard do you think it will hit the TOs of Smash 4? Depends on the TOs. Because some events get gaming generations, and they'll flip the bill, and it sucks for them, but the TOs will be fine. For Xanadu, I don't know. Like, how's
bring
that
your own setup. Bring your own setup.
I guess so. Yeah.
Yeah, but how many people really... Like, what if like, Smash is on release? Because the Switch coming out in March. Smash on, what if like Smash on release or like in April? I feel like a lot of people won't even have Switches by then.
That's true.
So, you know, bring your own setup. I'm definitely not bringing my shit. I don't trust nobody. But we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. That's a good question. I feel like it'll get sorted out eventually. I don't know, like, what to say. So, that's, yeah. All right, let's get into the last few wave of comments. Since it's sort of winding down now. So let me go ahead. This isn't working for me for some reason, so I'm going to switch over here. on the earlier topic, would you rather commentate... This is from Ella Fox. How's it going, Ella Fox? Would you rather commentate at a World Wonder with a few viewers or a big sports stadium like MSG? MSG.
MSG.
Absolutely.
The obvious answer.
That's basically like a World Wonder. MSG has so much history. If we're talking the Royal Farms Arena in Baltimore, then I would do the World Wonder with just a few viewers, because I don't give a shit, because Baltimore Arena is tiny. But, yeah. MSG, absolutely. It's not even a question. Connor Zombie, how can I get my hair as luscious as flowing as your... I don't have nice hair. It's lighting. It's a lighting trick. That's all it is. Laren, if the Switch Smash port is real... Would you like to see a new balance patch, or would you prefer the game stay as is?
We'd definitely like to see a new balance patch. I don't need too much change either. I just, you know, can we bring Cloud down into line to where, like, he doesn't seem to be winning everything anymore? At the very least, in dubs, though. Cloud is winning every dubs.
Yes.
Cloud, like, at the point where people are wondering if Cloud should be banned from dubs, and I usually don't like to throw out the ban thing, but I can definitely see the argument in general. But, like, yeah, if you bring Cloud down just a little more, that'd be dope. Give me another character.
Yeah. It's not ideal. I don't want to get too much into that. That stuff. But, yeah, I could see a little Cloud nerf. But doubles only. How do you touch him in doubles? Just finishing touch again?
I feel like, I don't know, man. I mean, I feel like you could just nerf him all around the board, just to make him kill like a little later, but like nothing crazy. Like maybe nerf some of his hitboxes as well.
Can't you just nerf combos into finishing touch? Like if finishing touch combos with a move, it has way less knockback. That would hurt him in singles, but like nobody's doing combos into finishing touch in singles anyway. That
I still am.
Like, I feel like you could just set that rule and then it would fix everything. But I don't know. Okay, anyway, maybe. Raycat says, assuming the Switch will allow custom gamepads / slides, whatever, what do you want to see from the Switch? In terms of, like, custom gamepad sides, all that stuff? I mean, I'm just going to use a GameCube controller, dude, so I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, just Nintendo, the GameCube controller is as big of a hit as Smash Bros. Itself. Just keep making it accessible for us to use. That's all we want. And it's not hard.
Yeah, and if you're talking non-Smash Bros., just like game in general, I feel like the possibilities are endless. It'll be great. So, Roger Sierra, two more questions. Roger Sierra, what was your favorite set of 2016 so far? Oh, good lord, dude.
It's tough.
That's really tough. I
that's always tough. So I always just go with what my recent favorite set was, and it was
exactly yeah.
It was definitely Mr. E vs. Nairo or second set or first set or grand finals. Abadango versus Zero because he finally got game.
Yeah.
A couple games with that.
Void versus Esam was really good at UGC. Like, there's so many good sets. You can't really. I actually really like watching Mr. R against Kameme. They play a lot. Mr. R, like, used to always, like, be pulling out really far ahead, and then Kameme would just win the game, and then the set, and then the... But, like, I really like watching those two play, but that's not, like, my favorite set. It's hard to say. There are a lot of good sets. Abadango yeah. versus Mars at Pound, that's another good one. Yeah. A lot of good things.
Mine was probably Anti versus Zero at Big House, Winners Finals. I like that a lot.
That's a good answer.
Good answer.
Zenodo Anti CEO, the grands where he went cloud last game. Like, that's a lot of good sets, man. A ton of good sets. All right, Chew BCX, last question of the night, then we're going to cut it. Why do people want Ice Climbers when people already hate Rosalina and Luna? Legacy. That's it. People just want Ice Climbers because they've been in the other games. People don't actually like
Ice Climbers. I don't even think people really want Ice Climbers in the first place.
No.
You always want what you can't have and bet money to the same people. I would literally look, wait for someone to tweet, and then if they tweeted they were complaining, I would control F their whole timeline for Ice Climbers. Wait till Ice Climbers come back.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
CFICS. Like, you'll find it. There it is. All right. Anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching Blast Zone. That's going to cut it. We're going to call it right there. Pretty long show. So, thank you guys for watching. We do this, we try to do it every 2 weeks, but with tournaments and other stuff happening, sometimes we can't.
Yeah, January, man, good luck.
That's going to be, because you got, like, all of us have MAGFest, all of us have Genesis, you guys have the other shit. I'm going to go see Hamilton at one point, and I don't
know. We could do the MAGFest show. I mean, we do the one right after MAGFest, I mean.
Yeah. We'll see.
But then we have to do, well, shit.
We'll figure it out. Anyway, I'm trying to... Whatever. We'll wrap it up. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. You guys want to do your things. Do your things. TK.
I'm TK Breezy, man. I'll be streaming sometimes. But 2017, man. 110 hours per month, regardless of if I'm going to tournaments or not. I'm going to kill myself, but it's going to be dope. Subscribe to me for some dope emotes, or don't. Just come through every now and then. And then, also, I think I'm going to get back into Rocket League, because I just need a game to be able to play that isn't Smash.
Yeah, actually, I've been looking at some of the updates they've been doing on Rocket League, so if you want to play sometime, let me know. Actually, it looks pretty cool.
Alright, well, first of all, alright, man, as long as I'm going against you, we can't be on teams.
Yeah, of course, nigga. Rivalry.
Alright, we'll do that. And if you happen to be a Rocket League player, then that's dope. But yeah, no, I was trying to push Final Fantasy so much, and I feel like that's just not a game people care to see me play, which kind of sucks, because I'm still going to play it 100% it, but
yeah.
No one cares, so now I'm just going to go back and try to get better at Smash and get on the side while I play this
game.
But yeah, Rocket League coming back. Follow me on Twitter for updates, because it's way easier to follow me on Twitter instead of expecting me to just stream on time, because like, I'll be asleep. Yeah.
Yep. Cool.
Yeah, you already know. I mean, follow me on Twitter if you want. Follow the stream. I stream all the time. It's just basically me just talking shit, having a good time, so... If you like to talk shit and have a good time, come check me out, man. I'd be more than happy to have you.
Alright, guys. Thank you guys for watching. That's going to be our stream. We'll do this again probably in 2 weeks, but you know how it is. Schedules permitting. Benji, you want to say goodbye? We can say goodbye. Why is he wet? Why are you wet? Oh, God. Alright, anyway. Alright, guys. Thank
2 weeks
guys
will be 26.
There we go. Okay.
2 weeks will be the day after Christmas. We should be able to do that.
Mallory gave him a bath? He's all... He smells all like... Did she spray him with something?
That ain't bath water, mate.
What the fuck? All right, did you... I think she sprayed him with perfume. I don't know what...
I told... She's drinking. I'm telling you, I ain't joking, nigga.
Something's going on with him. I'm gonna... All right. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'm out. We'll be back in a few weeks. We'll see you at Zero Saga this weekend. Anyway, have a good night.
We're gone. Drinking. Take care, guys. I'm telling you, I ain't joking.
Wow, what an absolutely incredible stream from me, the Honorable Grand King Coney ZZ. One that will go down in the history books as the best Twitch broadcast of all time. We laughed, cried, and maybe even learned a little something along the way. What was your favorite part of the stream? That was my favorite part too. Please don't cry, though our adventures are coming to an end. Let us always remember the good times. I say to you, my fellow kings, dry your tears. The stream may be over, but its cherished memory will live forever on in our hearts. Until next time, my name is Coney ZZ, and thank you for watching my stream. Go the fuck to sleep.